Sterling Golden Warriors. It's time to meet tonight's starting lineups. First, let's meet the Vikings from Guilford. Starting us off, we have sophomore number 0, Landon Horn.
Sophomore number 0, Landon Horn.
Number 3, Julian Rodriguez.
Number 3, Julian Rodriguez.
Sophomore number 6, Andrew Bakta.
Number 6, Andrew Bakta.
Senior number 7, Ben Matena.
Ben Matena.
Sophomore number 8, Leonardo Hernandez.
Number 8, Leonardo Hernandez.
Junior number 9, Cesar Rodriguez.
Number 9, Cesar Rodriguez.
Senior number 13, Joe Prince Matena.
13, Joe Prince Matena.
Freshman number 16, Jose Lara.
Number 6, Jose Lara.
Sophomore number 17, Alexis Perez.
Number 17, Alexis Perez.
Freshman number 21, Saw Blair.
Number 21, Saw Blair.
And sophomore number 23, Daniel Martinez.
Number 23, Daniel Martinez. That's the lineup for the Rockford Guilford Vikings.
And now let's meet the starting lineup for your Sterling Golden Warriors.
And now it's
starting
lineup.
Starting us off, we have senior number 46, Rex Blackburn.
Number 46, Rex Blackburn, senior.
Senior number 1, Ivan Marion.
Number 1, Ivan Marion.
Senior number 7, Chris Martinez.
Number 7, Chris Martinez.
Freshman number 9, Mauricio Herrera.
Mauricio Herrera, number 9.
Junior number 11, Anthony Rosas.
Number 11, Anthony Rosas.
Senior number 12, Adrian Cervantes.
Number 13, Adrian Cervantes.
Senior number 12, 13,
I mean.
Luis Milan.
Number 13, Luis Milan.
Junior number 14, Ian Hilty.
Number 14, Ian Hilty.
Sophomore number 16, Kevin Reese.
Number 16, Kevin Reese.
Sophomore number 21, Derek Prieto.
Number 1, Derek Prieto.
And freshman number 30, Felipe Vasquez.
Number 30, Felipe Vasquez.
The officials for today's contest are Mr. Dan Jordan and Mr. Randy Mock. Are located on the back side of the stadium, and your concession stand is open, serving up the snacks you need for tonight's exciting match. Stop on now. Go get them, Warriors!
Alright, Rockford Guilford coming in 1-2-1. They're 1-2 overall in the Nick 10 Conference. Sterling is 3-4-1, 0-2 in the Western Big Six. As we are about to get underway between Rockford Guilford and Sterling. Vasquez to kick the open kick, and we are underway. Sterling and Guilford. So it'll be Marion now. Well, not Marion. Well, hard to tell by the numbers. You just can't see the numbers really well. But it's whatever. Well, some of them I can recognize. And Guilford's going to start with some passing on. Looking to go for a goal, and It's going to be a goal for Guilford. And that is number... I don't know who scored a goal. Actually. You know, this is different. You know, soccer, you know, I can tell for football, like for touchdowns. I could tell from football. I could tell. But it's whatever. And that is blocked. Sterling on defense. Looking to respond. Yeah, it's gonna be Rosas. Now to Reese, to Tito. Ferreira now. Now back to Reese. And a Sterling ball gives it to Herrera. That's a... picked up there by Martinez. Back to the other Martinez on the Guilford. That's going to go out of bounds. And it's going to be Guilford ball, but there's a... That's going to go out of bounds, but back with Guilford. And it's going to be Sterling ball. Sterling ball. I can say some of these goalies can kick the soccer ball far. They can kick the soccer ball far. We're still 1-0. Guilford with the lead. And we got a... I don't know what it's called. What they call... I don't know the call. Got injured player on the field. I think it's an injured Guilford Viking. Thank you. Alrighty, we're tied at one current right now. Start of the second half. Here. Our big week of football coming up tomorrow night as well. So we have some teams that are 0-2 that are looking to get their first win tonight. Looking to get their first win not tonight, but tomorrow night as well. One of the teams is Sterling. So the Golden Warriors tomorrow night against United Township. If they can pull it off tomorrow night versus UT, their playoff hopes are still alive. They're still alive if they can pull it off tomorrow night as well against United Township and get the win. But if they lose and go 0-3, I could say, you know, this could be the first time that we have seen that, you know, in this area that we have seen a Sterling team go 0-3. Because I bet you it's been probably been a long time since we have seen the Sterling Golden Warrior football team go 0-3 as well. And then across the river, Rock Falls needs to get the win to hopefully, you know, hopefully have that stride coming into this week. Hopefully shock everyone and beating Dixon, you know, tomorrow night. If they can pull it off tomorrow night, if they shock Dixon tomorrow night at home, and that could prove that Rockballs can hang with anybody in the conference. Hang with anybody in the Big Northern Conference as well. or it could prove that, because the last 2 weeks we've seen Rock Falls kind of improve that, you know, that for them it takes improvement in the Big Northern Conference. And one of the biggest matches in the Big Northern is Byron taking on Williamsville. Down in Williamsville, a rematch of the 2017 playoff matchup between these two, where Byron won that matchup as well. They did meet in the state championship in Class 3A in 2019. Williamsville won that in a shootout as well. And that game, Byron was supposed to play Radford Christian. Well, they're supposed to play him this week, but Radford Christian canceled the varsity football season right at the beginning of the football season this year as well. And then up in Erie on Friday night as well, we have the Newman Comets and the Erie P-Town Panthers, another Free Rivers rivalry matchup. EP, they're on a hot streak right now, starting off 2-0, picking up their first two wins over Kewaunee week one, and then over Spring Valley Hall last week. Newman, they start off 0-1 week one, losing their season opener to the Princeton Tigers. But came in week two on Saturday night here, and shout out or shootout or in a shutout where they beat Mendota 42-0. Some of the matchups this week going on, or the matchups tomorrow night for football as well. Because week three is all about, you know, the playoff race. Thank you.
fouls would be nice.
Whoa, what kind of wrestling move was that? This ain't WWE. Soccer players trying to do moves that they watch. Yeah, still.